Welcome to West Coast Views. I would much rather be behind the wheel of my boat than in front of a camera. Sorry for the lengthy intro, and I promise the videos that follow will be much more interesting. Just going to do a little unboxing video of this brand new Mercury 9.9 electric start outboard 2025. So my dealer delivered it in this box. Kind of cool. And I just slid it open. We'll take a look inside. Well, take a look here. We'll open her up. And it's all nicely packed, I would think. And we've got the outboard standing up here. And what's in this box here? Oh, this is the gas tank. Comes with a, I believe, 12-liter gas tank. And there we go. I'll take care of this wrapping here. Just slide the styrofoam out. And that's what you see when you unwrap it. Oh, there's a liter of oil. Dealer told me that they removed the oil for shipping, and then they give you a complimentary liter of oil to install before you fire it up. So that's how it looks in the box. And now I'll unbox it the rest of the way and put it on the stand, and we'll take a look at it. Now, one thing I notice here is that I was told by the dealer Mercury's gone with a new fuel input to the outboard, so you may have compatibility issues. I guess if you're trying to use an old tank as a spare, then you might have to get one of these connectors. So it's definitely something different than what they used to have. Okay, well, nice and clean, as it should be. So there's what we're looking at. Now they got the electric start on this model, and one thing I don't like is the cable just runs straight in. In my case, I'm going to be removing it on and off the dinghy, and I don't want to be taking it off the battery every time. So what I've found is a solution that works pretty well. I did it on another outboard, and I'll show you in a second. So what I picked up is a Scotty downrigger plug and receptacle. It's a Canadian company here. I use them only for downriggers and prawn haulers, and it's good for like 40 amps. So works pretty good. I just seal it up on the cable, and then I can unplug it and remove it when necessary. Now this model has the shifter on the tiller. So you shift forwards, pushing this way, and then increase the throttle and reverse the other way. I think that's going to be a good operation. We'll see when we use it. Okay, I'll remove the cover and see what we got underneath. So what these smaller outboards have, instead of an alternator, AC is generated by the stator, and it's they use a rectifier right here to convert it to DC. So that's what we're seeing there. Oil fill here. And here, I guess they put this on just to stop the cables from coming undone during shipping. So got a oil dipstick here, and EFI, so there's no carb, so we got fuel injection happening there. Looks kind of nice. I'm looking forward to not having a problem with ethanol in the fuel and having to deal with the carburetor all the time. Now, I was told by the dealer that the preferred method of flushing is to use this flush here. Just connect the hose and let her go without the engine running. But I've heard conflicting reports too that it's better for a complete flush to use the old earmuffs down below. But anyone has any comments about what they know or have heard, that'd be great. I guess I'll go with the dealer recommendation though and just use the hose inside without the engine running. And with this electric start model, it's hardwired in through the engine cowling, and I'm not sure why they don't offer an option for disconnect. For those of us that have a dinghy that are slinging it on and off, it's kind of awkward to be feeding that cable in and out. And so here's the finished product with the Scotty downrigger connector now on the electrical connection from the engine. It's a nice relatively sealed unit with good quality connectors. Now my only other dilemma with this outboard is I'm going to be mounting it on the back of the boat and with a hoist swinging it onto the inflatable dinghy, and I don't know exactly how I'm going to do that. They don't really make a mount as such up here like the 15, which has a solid attaching point for a hoist. So I'm going to have to try and figure something out by running a webbing sling underneath here somewhere without damaging that shifter rod. Any comments or ideas would be greatly appreciated. Thanks, and thanks for watching the video.